Hi, thank you very much for coming. Thank you. I think that one of the reasons that I became an actress is because I have this quality about me in everyday life, or, well, at least when I'm not in a theater, that says to the world, please ignore me. I do not exist. For example, when I go to Starbucks, and this has happened to me so many times that I know it must be a reflection on me and not on them, but I'll be standing obediently in the order line, and I'll love the smell of the place, and I'll be really excited for the coffee I'm gonna get. And the girl behind the cash register will have like a nose ring and a tattoo and a partially shaved head. And I'll think, I'm so glad that I've chosen to live in a big city where people can indulge their eccentricities. And I love that Starbucks is this huge corporation, and yet they encourage their personnel to be so alternative. Well, then the person a couple in front of me in line will order, and he'll say something like, I'll have a double tall latte. And then right away, the girl behind the cash register will yell out, double tall latte, to that guy over by the cappuccino machine, who will immediately yell back, double tall latte, and then everybody's got the message. And then he'll pay and move over to the pickup area, and the woman in front of me will move up, and she'll inevitably be a middle-aged woman in like a lavender running suit with a gray bob, not in a rural perm, because she's more sophisticated than that. And she'll order something like a triple percent foamy cap with a shot of vanilla. And then she'll turn around and look at me like, I know how to say it. And then right away, the girl behind the cash register will yell out, triple percent foamy cap shot vanilla. And immediately you hear back, triple percent foamy cap shot vanilla. And then she'll pay and move over to the pickup area. And then I'll move up and I'll say, yes, I'd like a grande non-fat latte. And the girl will say, uh-huh. And I'll say, grande non-fat latte. And she'll say, do you want two? And it's at that moment that I start this inner monologue and I start thinking, you know, your tattoo and nose ring are dumb and ugly and they're not accentuating your best features, although I'm not sure that you have any. But of course I don't say this, and I'm all cowed by her sarcastic response, and so I say, no, just one, and then I pay and slither over to the pickup area where the guy who ordered the double tall latte gets his latte, and the woman who ordered the triple percent foamy cap gets her cap, and then the person behind me gets their drink, and the person behind them gets their drink, and once again, I'll realize that they've forgotten me, and what should I do, and who should I tell, and at what point should I interject it, and how it's also unfair because I have that quality that says, I do not exist. Well, then I'll finally go up to the guy behind the cappuccino machine, and I'll say, excuse me, I think you might have forgotten a grande non-fat latte. And then he'll turn to the girl behind the cash register and say, did she order a grande non-fat latte? And then, and this has happened to me more than once, she'll say, oh, just give her one. Like, I would go to all this trouble to scam them out of a $2 coffee drink. So I think that might be one of the reasons that I became an actress. So for all of the time that I spend out in the world where people notice me less often than I'd like, I do something like this, and I get up on a stage, and I talk out to you, and I have you sit out there and just stare back at me. And I just wanted to say thank you in advance.